It is time for me to go now, but I need not say goodbye. You can look for me in rainbows, way up in the sky. And in the morning sunrise, when all the world is new, just look for me and love me as you know that I loved you. Then in the evening sunset, when all the world is through, just look for me and love me, and I'll be close to you. Every waking moment and all your whole life through, just wish me to be near you, and I will be there with you. Dawson Lemuel Chandler of Canefield St. Thomas and formerly of Highland St. Thomas, supervisor of One Sandy Lane, faithful member of the Rock Hall Community Seventh-day Adventist Group, Rock Hall St. Thomas, entered peacefully into rest on Sunday, December 17, 2023, at the age of 57. Dawson Lemuel Chandler, husband of Glenda Whittington Chandler, father of Soraya Chandler, adoptive father of Shem White, son of Ruthina Chandler, brother of Eri and Junior Chandler, Oriane Cullimore, Aileen Hines, Sandra Griffith, and Tamisha Harding, son-in-law of the late Yvonne Whittington, brother-in-law of Waveney and the late Ian Whittington, Jeffrey Cullimore, and Albert Hines, uncle of Destiny Alexander, Xavier Cullimore, Kim Nurse, and Bria Rudder, nephew of Cynthia, Udell, and Goldine Chandler, and Glendine Smith, cousin of Ophelia, Kenville, Paul, and Cameron Chandler, Ricardo and Mario Smith, Flavia and Ian Drakes, and many others. Godfather of Theo Clark, a friend of Junior, Onita, Genevieve and Jacqueline Clark, Christine Smith, Valcia Scott, Wesley Webb, Cheryl Jones, Sean Paris, Deidre Greenidge, the management and staff of One Sandy Lane, the members of the Welchman Hall Seventh-day Adventist Church, the members of the Rock Hall Community Seventh-day Adventist Group, and others too numerous to mention. A service of thanksgiving to celebrate the life of Dawson Lemuel Chandler takes place at the Jackson Seventh-day Adventist Church, Canewood Road, Jackson, St. Michael, on Thursday, January 18th, 2024, at 11 o'clock in the morning. The interment will follow in the St. James Cemetery. Funeral arrangements have been entrusted to the care of Anderson Funeral Home, Lower Barbies Hill, St. Michael. You may join the family for the live streaming of the service and the interment at sharingmemoriesforever.live/Dawson Chandler.
For your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. You have led me through the fire, and in darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Oh, yes, you have.
And all my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Like an eagle, and I will soar with you.
soul with you. Your spirit leads me on in the power of your
with my phone just now, we're reminded to please turn off. All phones must go on silent. And by special request of the family, at this time we will start with a word of prayer. Let's stand for a word of prayer. Then we'll have some free tributes. They're not on the program, but as you desire, you're encouraged to give your tribute for the family and for the life of Brother Dawson. Let's pray. Dear God and Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for the blessings of the day. We want to thank you for family. We want to thank you for friends. As we come this morning, though it be a sad occasion, we want to thank you, Lord, for the lives that we are living and the lives that we are supposed to live through your word. As we go through today, Lord, I ask that you would indeed send your Holy Spirit to comfort, send your Holy Spirit to dwell and live among us. Thank you for everything that you will do for us throughout today. This is my prayer, for Christ's sake. Amen. Be seated. And with no further ado, at this time, the floor, the microphone, my microphone is open to you, those of you who wants to pay tribute to the family and Brother Dawson. At this time, you don't have to have a number. I don't know nobody's face. So I want to call on you. So as you, your heart desire, you are free to come. Who will be the first one? So as the technician plays some music in the background, we don't have all morning. You have about 25 minutes or so before the official start. So please, let's utilize that time wisely. So while the music is played, you can gather your thoughts together, and the first person, you can come.
The Adventist Church, and knowing him, he was very, very quiet. He is humble, and he's a very strong man, very strong indeed. And from the Rock Hall, when I saw him, he was very strong at the time, and he never talked much, but whenever he says something, it's deep. And I remember we were discussing probation closing. And I said to him, you know, well, when probation closes, there's no more forgiveness. And I said to him, you know, Satan is going to have more people than God. And he said, no, he can't believe that. I said to him, well, the Bible says, broad is the way that leads to destruction, and narrow is the way that leads eternal life. So apparently, he went to the back and he was discussing it with another person. To my surprise, one day he came and to collect some stuff from me, and I gave him, and Then another time, this guy came to me and he said, "You remember the guy that came to you to collect the stuff?" I said, "Yeah." He said, "He dead, you know." I said, I couldn't believe it, really, because he went to work this Sunday. He talked to us this Saturday in church, because we all are at Seventh-day Adventist. And he spoke to me, we sat and we talked and everything like that. And when I heard that he passed, I was like, I can't take it. But to God be the glory. May he rest in peace.
My name is Veronica Marshall Barnett, and I was asked actually to do this tribute on behalf of my aunt, Vernice, who happened to be a good friend of Dawson. And I'm sending also a condolencing on behalf of the Marshall Barnett and Nichols family, Augustine's also. I'll try my best to do this one. God promised to take care of all his children, yeah, when they're going through some rough times in their lives, when it seems like all around you have fallen, and the devil tells you you cannot win, only believe. Put your faith and your trust in the Lord. He will deliver right on time. So before the day is over, before the night is through, you will find the answer. My God will come through for you, 'cause you've been praying for deliverance. That is worth his assurance. Oh, before the day is over, my God will come through for you. So whenever you are faced with your problems, yeah, oh, give them to Jesus. My God, I know he'll lift your heavy burdens. He's a faithful friend to those who loved and trust him. Oh, there is nothing too hard for my God to do. Oh, he's a mighty God, a Prince of Peace. There is no one like the Lord Jesus. Remember, there's a man in Gilead, yeah. And God will come true for you. So before the day is over, before the night is true, oh, you will find the answer. My God will come through for you, 'cause you've been praying for deliverance. That is worth his assurance. Oh, before the day is over, my God will come true for you. Yes, God will come true for you. My God will come true for you. Thank you.
Jesus, I'm alive. On behalf of Soraya's peers and classmates,
we would like to send our blessings to the friends and
family of Dawson Chandler.
I hope she has a safe recovery with all she's going through.
And we are here for her.
And I would like to say I'm sorry.
Church. I just want to come and give this tribute to Dawson. He was a wonderful, wonderful person. My name's Sharon Hinkson. I worked with him for 8 years. I knew Dawson to be a man of faith, strong faith in God. And Dawson knew whose he was, and that made him who he was. He was a man, a wise man. He was a humble man. A gentleman, but a gentleman as well. Dawson was very generous, very giving. He was very quiet, you know. But with those who were close to him, he wasn't afraid to share his feelings if he felt strongly about something. I feel blessed that I knew Dawson. There were not many men like him. He was a man of dignity, a man of strength, meekness, quiet strength, quiet determination. Anything that he decided that he wanted to do, he put his mind to it, he made a plan, and he quietly executed. And I was really, really impressed with him as a human being. He was lovely. And I really feel blessed that I knew him. And all of you who are here this morning, who knew Dawson, I think we were all blessed to know him. And to be friends with him, to be in the company of such a wonderful person. I want to say to his wife, I told her just now, that she was blessed, that he chose her to be his wife, to be loved by him. To his stepson, I want to say that Dawson is a wonderful example to emulate. He walked with strength, he walked with dignity, he placed his faith in God, he walked with wisdom, and those are qualities to emulate. And I want to say to his daughter, when she's looking for a partner, choose somebody. Remember her father and choose somebody who has those same qualities. She can't go wrong with making a choice like that. God bless all of you.
Good morning. We are Dawson co-workers, and we are the housekeeping department, and Shakira used to work with us. Dawson was my friend, not just any friend. We came there together, we worked together at One Sand Lane for 15 years, and every day we shared God, every day we shared food, every day we shared everything. We were close. And at One Sand Lane with Dawson in the housekeeping department, we were very close. And every day, I just want to share this, every day Dawson would come and look for us around 1:30 to make sure that the housekeepers were okay and to share the word of God. We would spend time together. If he didn't see us, he would always make sure that he come and look for us to just make sure that we were okay. Dawson was one of the most loving, kindest persons that I have ever met. And it was genuine. You could have talked to Dawson about anything. I know that it was just die dear. He was my prayer partner at work. Anytime I had a problem or anything, something was bothering me, we would always go somewhere and we would have a word of prayer. He had faith that was unshakable, and that's what I held on to. If they needed help outside of work with any work, doing anything, advice, Dawson was there to help me. And I miss Dawson. I miss Dawson to my heart, breaking. And one of the things that gives me joy is knowing that Dawson lived a life of peace. And whether it was a death on plan, he died a death of peace. And that gives me joy to know that when God comes for his world again, that Dawson is going to be one of those. He made me want to live a life also to be like him, so that when Christ comes for his world, I can be one with him.
I just want to sing this song for the family, giving strength. It's laid heavily on my heart, and if you know it, you can sing along with me. It says, there's coming a day when our heartache will come. No more clouds in the sky, no more tears to dim the eye. There'll be peace forevermore on the happy golden shore. What a day, a glorious day that will be. There is coming a day when our heartache shall come. No more cloud in the sky, no more tears to dim the eye. All is peace forevermore on that happy golden shore. What a day, glorious day that will be. Oh, what a day that will be. When my Jesus I shall see, when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when he takes me by the hand and lead me through the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. There'll be no sorrow there, no more burden to bear, no more sickness, no pain, no more parting over there. All will be peace forevermore on that happy golden shore. What a day, glorious day that will be. Oh, what a day that will be. When my Jesus I shall see, when I look upon his face, the one who saved me by his grace, when he takes me by the hand and he lead me through the promised land. What a day, glorious day that will be. Hallelujah.
Good morning, all. My name is Shakira Smith, and I would have had the awesome privilege to know Dawson for 11 years. I just want to say a heartfelt and sincere condolences to his wife, his children, his mom, and everybody. And I just want to share one of the very last sweet but real experiences that I would have had with Dawson. He would have came by the house after I had the baby. He said he came just to see my face and to make sure that everything was okay. And he stood by the door. And I said to him, Dawson, why are you at the door? And he said, you know, you just had the baby and the germs and they don't want to come in or whatever. And I said to him, please come into the house because we never know when is the end. And I wouldn't want the memories that I have of you to be with you by the door. I came in and he gave me a hug and he said, God bless, he prayed for the baby. And, you know, I'm grateful to God that it came to my spirit to invite him in and to embrace him and to have him embrace me and to pray for the baby, because I promise you, I did not know that that was going to be the last embracing and personal time that I would have with Dawson. I'm sorry today that I didn't come before Sharon, because she said everything about Dawson. His meekness, his gentleness, his quietness, his spirit. He's one to emulate. He's one to, that will never be forgotten. I've never seen Dawson angry in 11 years. Everything he says with a warmness and a smile. He is brilliant. They say that it takes a village to raise Dawson, to raise a child, sorry. And I would like to meet the village that raised Dawson. To his mom and to everyone that had a hand in Dawson, y'all did an excellent, excellent job, because there's not one thing that anybody can say that they wish was different about Dawson. He was an excellent man, and I'm thankful that I had the opportunity to work with him and to have him as a friend. Thank you.
In your presence, I speak, Jesus. I just want to speak the name of Jesus till every dark addiction starts to break, declaring there is hope and there is freedom. I speak, Jesus. Your name is power. Your name is healing. Your name is life. Break every stronghold. Shine through the shadows. Burn like a fire. Over fear and all anxiety, to every soul held captive by depression, I speak, Jesus.
Morning, church.
We're both Dawson sisters.
From a different mother. I would echo everything that everyone has said before. I know today that Dawson is in the arms of Jesus. No doubts. We don't have to worry if he made it in or not. We know. He wasn't perfect, but he was a gem. And when I was told that Dawson died, first thing I asked was Dawson ill? But we don't know when that day will come for us. But one thing I will say is that Dawson was ready. And that brings me much joy, even though we cry at times, because we will remember Dawson. It brings me a lot of joy to know that Dawson was a gem. And yes, his wife, she was blessed to have him, you know. And I just pray that all of us going forward will just live that life of peace. That life that we know that if God shall call us home, we all will be ready. And that is my little tribute.
Let us stand, please. Lord, thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever thou hadst formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. Thou turnest man to destruction and sayest, return, ye children of men. For 1,000 years in thy sight are but as yesterday, when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Thou carriest them away as a flood. They are as asleep. In the morning, they are like grass, which grow up. In the morning, it flourishes and grows up. In the evening, it is cut down and it withers. For we are consumed by thine anger, and by wrath are we troubled. Thou hast set our iniquities before thee, our secret sins in the light of thy countenance. For all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our years as a tale that is told. The days of our years are 70 years, and if by reason of strength they be 80 years, yet is their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off and we fly away. Who knoweth the power of thine anger? Even according to thy fear, so is thy wrath. So teach us to number days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Return, O Lord, how long? And let it repent thee concerning thy servants. O satisfy us early with thy mercy, that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Make us glad according to the days wherein thou hast afflicted us, and the years wherein we have seen evil. Let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us, and establish thou the work of our hands upon us. Yea, the work of our hands, establish thou it. On behalf of my family, the members of the Rock Hall Seventh Adventist Church, the family members gathered here, we want to extend to you our words of condolence. In a time that is difficult to deal with, but because of God, we are able, because he walks us through the difficulties, the challenges of this life. As we worship together in thanksgiving to God for the life of someone who has been a blessing to us, I pray that the peace of God be yours today. God bless you.
To those of you who are on the outside, we still have some seats upstairs and also some at the front. So if you want to be seated, you can. You can make your way to the balcony, or you can find some space at the front. We gather today under very difficult circumstances. Difficult circumstances to give a welcome. Difficult circumstances to say good morning. And so we are gathered here the best way we know how to try to make the best out of a difficult situation. On behalf of the family, we want to thank all of you for being here to support them during this very difficult and challenging time. I trust that this service in some way will serve as a means of encouraging and comforting every heart that is grieving today. And so we want to sing our first hymn, This Is My Father's World.
This is my Father's world.
Let us all bow our heads for prayer. Gracious God and loving Father, which art in heaven, we have assembled here on this morning, Lord, to celebrate the life of our dear brother, Dawson Chandler. Father, even as we recognize the fact that he has passed, Lord, we know, the Father, that you are our comforter. And all we need to do, Lord, is look to you for comfort. And you, Lord, will grant us, because you've told us that you are a God that cares and you care for us. Gracious Father, I pray to God that as we assemble here, that we recognize, Lord, that as long as we give our lives to you, when we die, that we will live again, because you've promised us that all who die in you will not lose their life, but they will gain it. So I pray, dear Father, that each one here now bowed in your presence will recognize this truth and give their lives to you, Lord, so that when that time comes, and you burst as the skies, Lord, that we'll be among the first who rise to meet you in the air. Now, Father, continue, Lord, to be with the family members, because we know, Lord, that things will be a bit tough even now. But I pray, dear God, that they will seek you in all things so that the comfort that they need, they'll find in you. The rest that they need, they'll find in you. And as a result, Lord, we'll help this process to pass, as all things must pass. So bless us this day, Father. In the end, we give you all the praise and the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
Please be seated. Just want to let you know that as the brochure indicates, our program will run in the brochure. So if you have a task to perform, just look and see where you are and follow suit. We will begin with the first scripture reading, and then the program follows unannounced. Thank you.
first scripture reading comes from chapter 21 of Revelation, reading from number 1 to number 5. Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 to 5. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. Neither shall there be any more pains, for the former things are passed away." And he that sat upon the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." And he said unto me, "Write, for these words are true and faithful." Here endeth the reading.
Blessed good morning to everyone. I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fail me all my days. I've been held in your hands from the moment that I wake up until I lay my head. I will sing of the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice, for you have led me through the fire. In darkest nights, you are close like no other. I known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. Some call him Savior, the Redeemer of men, but I call him Jesus, for he's my dearest friend. Thank you, Lord. And when it feels no one can help you, and your life is out of hand, and I know a man who can. I don't know how many of you can testify. Oh, but some call him Savior, the Redeemer of men. And I call him Jesus, for he's my dearest friend. Thank you, Jesus. And when it feels no one can help you, and your life is out of hand, but I know a man who can. I'm just going to sing it one more time. Oh, Lord, and some call him Savior, my God, the Redeemer of men. I call him Jesus, for he's my dearest friend. Thank you, Jesus. And when it feels no one can help you, and your life is out of hand, I know a man who can. And when it feels no one can help you, and your life is out of hand, and I know a man who can. And when it feels no one can help you, and your life is out of hand, I know a man who can. Hallelujah.
Good morning, everybody. I didn't want to come up here twice, so I will give my tribute now. Dawson was my neighbor. I could safely say I live in the best community in Barbados. Canefield people, just raise your hands. Yes, we live in the best community in Barbados. I am not a gardener, but Dawson made me feel as though I was a gardener. And whatever plan I had for my yard, he would bring for Cheryl and I, and he will just bring plants. And the last time he did my yard, my husband went away, and we wanted to surprise him because we thought it was a great plan, and we dug up the yard, and Dawson did what I had to do. I don't think my husband was impressed, but we were happy. Okay? So, Dawson was a very good neighbor and a good friend, a good person. And now my plants, I have weeds and stuff, and up to this morning, Cheryl was telling me, Kanetta, you have to dig it up. And every time I pass my plants in front, I stroops my mouth. Because I know if I had started digging and I look across and the ZR come up, Dawson will come out, go inside, change his clothes, and it was just this unspoken thing. He would come over, start weeding with me, Cheryl will come out, the three of us would be there until night. So I may not have known Dawson for 20, 30 years, but his friendship was quality friendship. And I thank God that I had the opportunity to know him, and I thank God that Dawson was the person he was. So I pray as I sing this song, you are comforted to know that even when we are going through what we are going through, God understands.
All things work for our good, though sometimes we can't see how they could. Struggles they break our hearts into, sometimes blind us to the truth. Our Father knows what's best for us. His ways are not our own. So when your pathway grows dim and you just can't see him, remember you're never alone. God is too wise to be mistaken. God is too good to be unkind. So when you don't understand, when you don't see his plan, when you can't trace his hand, trust his heart. When you don't see his hand,
scripture read.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
The scripture reading is taken from 1 Thessalonians 4, verses 13 to 18. But I will not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Here ends the scripture reading.
Dawson Lemuel Chandler, the second of five children. He was a man of few words who loved to laugh. If he had a joke to tell you, it was going to tear him away as he would be dying with laughter. If you were to hold him in conversation, he would be talking and he would just have his legs spread apart, one hand across his chest and the other underneath his chin and just listen. If it warrants a reply, he would say, "For real." And that's it. He hated noise and confusion. Many a time he saved me from a beating. I remember one day I wanted to go to the theater. I knew if I had told a man, as she is affectionately called, I wanted to go to the theater, she said no. So I lied and I said, "Ma, I want to go to the hospital to look for a girl. Would you let me go?" She said, "Okay." Not knowing that the next day, Sunday, my cousin came to the house, and with his mouth blurred out, "I saw you in the theater." I bring God off his throne. Not me. You ain't see me in no theater, but heading for the door, because I know lit was going to be shared. Dawson saw me in the theater also, but kept his mouth shut. And as I continue to argue, "You ain't see me in no theater," I wasn't in no theater. I headed for the yard. Dawson quietly come outside and said to me, "Stop arguing. I see you in the theater." To which my mouth was closed and the argument was done, but I kept far from her. If I was venting to him about something someone had did or said to me, all Dawson would look at me and say, "Don't mind them. You know them ain't gotten a lot of thinking powers too." Dawson loved to say that you didn't have any thinking powers. Dependable and trustworthy was his attributes. In other words, his morning words and evening words were the same. If he said he was going to do something for you, regardless of how long he took to do it, consider it will be done, but in his own time. He had an easy and economical way in which he moved. He acted as if he had all the time in the world to do or get where he was going. He took his time in everything. He was that easygoing. never in a hurry. Growing up, he was never one to play. I cannot ever recall him playing a sport. He enjoyed his own company and did things to make himself happy. Like the time he bought himself a harmonica and he decided to teach himself how to play. That was fun for us at nights or any time we heard him playing it. All over the place and blowing out of key. Had no tune and no, and you could not understand what he was blowing. Every time we laughed, he would just smile and say, oh, one of these days, I'm going to play a song for you all. That never happened. That said, harmonica almost cut Junior in his head a night when Junior decided to play a prank on Dawson with a game named Duck. For the love of me, I cannot understand why Dawson decided to play with Junior, Bimpy as he is affectionately called, because Dawson never used to play. As we were standing in by Ma's bedroom door, Bimpy come out and said, Dawson, everything I say, you say duck. Junior said, cow. Dawson said, duck. Junior said, run. Dawson said, duck. Junior said, slap. Dawson said, duck. And with that, the slap was round Dawson's head. And by the time Junior took off for the door, Dawson had the harmonica let go and barely missed Junior's head by a hump. All Dawson said, if you bad, come back in here. As quick as that anger was, it went. He was never one to hold on to anger. If you wanted to get him in a conversation, you had to be a plant lover or love nature. When we all had left home, Dawson used to get up early in the morning, eat his breakfast, not eggs or pancakes, food for breakfast, and head to the outdoors with his small radio in hand and his quarterly to get his passion going. As my sister, Helen, as she is affectionately called, will often say, Dawson can get a plant grow on a rock. Any type of plant you can think of, Dawson had it. He even had plants all in the yard where you had to walk. One day, Bimpy was walking in the yard and hit his foot on a plant pot. Bimpy got so mad and started to fret. Dawson just looked at him and looked off. Not a word. Bimpy threatened to throw the plant in the gully. Still not a word from Dawson. Bimpy turned to Ma and said, you are going to soon let him tear cut the flooring and plant plants just now. To which Ma simply replied, you see something wrong with that? Dawson saw a broken monkey pot and took it up. I said, Oscar, why you don't leave that? He just smiled and said he had used this for it. To my surprise, he did have a beautiful plant growing from it after it was placed on its side. He had helped many persons' plants come back to life from taking them into his care. Like when Destiny's grandmother, the late mama, had a lung tree which got blocked and she wanted to cut it down. Dawson gave her something to put on it and the tree started to bear like never before. She thanked Dawson repeatedly until the day she died. Every time you go and look at the lung tree or you go to the house, she would always say, I thank Dawson here. He's the one that saved this lung tree. I thank God for Dawson. One day, I asked him why he don't enter the gardening competition after helping Janice to win. He turned and said, all you get is seedlings. I got enough plants. Dawson was a jack of all trades, to which my sister Helen and I would laugh if we told him something had to be done. He liked a challenge and never backed down from any. Like for instance, Helen would say, Dawson, you have to call the tailor, to which he will reply, I could get that done. And he goes on to explain how and what needs to be done. Or she would tell him about the plumbing. Oh, that easy, I could get that done. Or the electrician, he could get all done. Then she would call me, sis, Dawson say he can get the things done, but I ain't no soul. because I don't want to turn on the news and see that man don't have anywhere to live, so what you think, sis? To which we would start laughing. She would turn and say, sis, he me well though. God bless his soul. To which I would reply, don't mix me, don't put me in nothing. Dawson loved life and loved to eat. So much so that his late grandmother Delsina gave him the name Fatter, because I was told he was fat as a child growing up. When we were younger, he used to buy my food for $1. Foolish me would sell him my food for $1, then to go out and buy a light pipe. and a drink. One day, I was severely sick with the influenza, to which man said to me, let me catch you in here selling your food again, and you will see. That was the end to the buying and selling. He would call me and say, Simon, you bake? To which I would reply, you bring something to help bake with? He would just laugh. He never called me anything else but Simon. I don't think for any minute any one of you all can see me and call me Simon. That was only for Dawson. I can recall Dawson getting angry twice in all my growing up. When my cousin Ophelia, Missy, as she is affectionately known to the family, cooked some peas and rice and chicken, she gave us some, Helen, Bimpy, and I. But Dawson one was put fit for a king. Rice plates neat. And rice plates neat with the chicken in its rightful place. But he got what we didn't, and that was salt meat. Helen and Bimpy took it upon themselves to eat the salt meat off Dawson's food. Dawson threatened them, and Missy was surely going to give them a beating. But just as quick as he was angry, that also was short-lived. He got his name Bush due to the fact of his knowledge about various bush you can use for colds and different ailments. One day, I had the cold, and he picked some sirsi bush for me to boil. Every morning, I would get up and drink a half cupful. I said to Dawson, every morning I drink this bush tea. Before I could finish my sentence, he turned and said, you expect to drink that every day? You don't drink bush tea like that? Head and met for hot only, you know. He was blessed with knowledge about plants. He had a green thumb. I remember when Dawson called and told me he was getting married. I replied, finally, congrats, to which he laughed. He then called me later on and told me Glenda was pregnant, to which I replied, okay, Abraham. We both laughed, and I continued to say, you got to be Abraham, boy, getting a child in your old age. We laughed controllably. Dawson loved a good laugh. And I, being the last sister, always act like the eldest. I would always, when he come in late or he don't call and say he's coming late, as he stepped through the door, I would be, you live in a house with people. You ain't live by yourself. You ain't have any sense to call and say you're coming late. To which he would just laugh and say, oh, you know, I got the answer to you. One day, I decided, as we go to church on Sabbath, I said to Dawson, okay, as you come in late, I will press your clothes. Not a presser, nor am I good at it, I decided to press Dawson's clothes for church. One Sabbath, everything went smooth. Next Sabbath, it wasn't too bad. But the third Sabbath, when Dawson took his pants to put it on, he said, Simon, you can't see. You here giving me this, hey, you get two seams in the pants. He said, anyhow, you don't press my clothes no more. He said, you don't press my pants anymore. I can do the pressing myself. You don't bother. So that was short-lived also. But I want to thank God for the years that I grew up with Dawson. He was nice, he was cool, he was firm in his teaching and discipline. And I'm thankful that Destiny got a part of that. And to Glenda, thanks for having you as a sister-in-law. God bless you. And I know that we will continue to rally with you as this is a very difficult time for us. But Dawson knew God. And God will continue to keep us, keep you and Soraya in his bosom. Thank you.
I will be giving a tribute on behalf of Dawson's lovely wife. I'll keep my personal tribute for her when I get home, lest I fill this platform with tears. I want you to understand when I say I am not, it's not me, this is his wife, right? So I'm going to read it now. I met Dawson Chandler through my brother Ian, who was just 19 at the time. Dawson was very fond of him and used to call him Short Man. I knew that Dawson had a thing for me. Woo! I'm reading this and I'm just trying to picture Dawson having a thing. Had a thing for me, as the old people would say, and I don't know why Glenda made me say that, because, you know, I had to shave a little bit so I don't be one of those old people. And on my way to school, I would see Dawson smiling at me. Dawson is a shorter boy. But never said a word. Not a word, boy, not a word. I could remember him giving me a ring then, not knowing at the time there would be a second ring coming. Of course, I took the ring back then despite being shy. Then are you shy? And decided to show it to my friend at school. I even lent the ring to her, which she ended up losing. My Lord. I was very upset about it and can't remember if I mentioned it to Dawson. We drifted apart at that time, but would run into each other occasionally. The Lord put Dawson in my life again from that time until December 17th, 2023, when his light unfortunately went out. Dawson was my friend, my lover, and my soulmate. He was everything to me. Even in my ups and downs, he never turned me away. After my mother's death, I went through a rough time and felt like I was going to die myself. But he never walked out on me and was by my side through thick and thin. We had a great journey together, even with Soraya. Our daughter was the joy of his life. That is so true, yes. I remember moving into community and seeing Dawson walking that girl child up and down, all over the place. Yeah, boy. Soraya, your daddy loved you. Though, through it all, I would miss the sound that only he could make with his mouth. I don't know what that sound is. Shem coming home with a joke, oh Lord, and we all laughing nonstop with tears in our eyes. He calling us termites in the house. He only knew why. I would miss him sitting at the table playing his relaxing games. Yes, Dawson did play some games. Yes, on his phone and was not there. I will miss calling him at work and asking what he was doing. I will miss his kisses and his hugs and his laughter. I will miss hearing him say, "I love you." Dawson, I will even miss your scent. Dawson loved. Dawson loved his plants, and if any of us messed with his plants, if we accidentally pushed one out of the way with our foot, he would ask if we couldn't see. He loved Mother Nature and God's natural beauty of creation. He wanted to visit different places just to see the beauty of it. This was his passion. He kept books about flowers and rocks and how to create a beautiful garden. As Ashley said in his letter, Dawson transformed the garden and the grounds where he worked with pride. Yes, he would always talk about, "I have that plant at work." He's always talking about his garden at work. He led by example, and his legacy will live on through his work and his dedication. There was an opportunity at work for persons to get a license to operate machinery, for example, forklifts. So I called Dawson to ask him if I should try. And he said, "Glenda, what should stop you from going?" He was also my inspiration to keep me going and never give up. Dawson loved a challenge. And when he set his mind to get something done, there was no turning back for Dawson. I went and I got my forklift license with tears in my eyes, because you are not here to celebrate with me. Dawson loved the Lord, his creator, and would spend time studying the word. If there was something he didn't understand during Bible study, he would go and research it to make sure that he finally got it. He believed in God with his heart and made things right with God through his recommitment. Dawson, God loved you back. My love, Shem, Saraya, your brothers, your sisters, and your mother. And I can add this one in, and the whole of the Caneville community. When Dawson passed, a whole community cried. And some of us, we are still crying, still in disbelief. We are going to miss you terribly. My love, my husband, it is hard to let you go, but I have to. This is the poem that you would have written to me, and it meant the world to me. Thank you, Dawson, your beloved wife. I'll read the poem now. Woo, love letters, boy. Shaba. I love you. That's the name of the poem. A poem for his wife. When I tell you, I love you. I want it to mean more than when anyone else in the whole world says it. I want it to mean that your happiness is everything to me, and that I want only the best for you always, no matter what it takes. I want it to mean that you are important to me, that you're important to me, that you are more important to me than anything else in the world. I surprised he didn't put including the plants. When I tell you I love you, I want it to mean that you're a part of me, and no matter what happens in this world, we'll be together forever, sharing our lives, our happiness, and our love. Signed, Dawson Chandler, 26th of October, 2002. That is love. Glenda, we know that Dawson loved you, and we know that you love Dawson. This is tribute from Glenda Chandler.
This song is a special tribute to the Chandler family from the Rock Hall community where Dawson is a member, was a member of. Thank you.
So let me say a special thanks to the Rock Hall Community Group for that lovely rendition, amen. And I do know it was difficult. Yeah. But God be praised. It goes without saying that a good man, a decent person has passed. And it's one thing to know that someone is sick and maybe they're going, but sudden death is never easy. And Glenda, I just want you to know our prayers continue to be with you, our support in whatever way we can do. Today we grieve the loss of a husband, a father, a son, a brother, maybe an uncle, a cousin, a fellow believer in Christ, a good neighbor, a friend, a former employee. And while heaven mourns with us today, while heaven sympathizes, yea, empathizes with us, there are feelings of ambivalence that surrounds the throne of God today. And I will tell you a little bit more as we go into the presentation. Let us pray. Father God, be in this place. You have promised to be our comforter. And we are claiming this promise today in Jesus' name on behalf of all who are mourning. Be with the ministry of your word. May accomplish that which you intend. You have promised that, and we claim that too in Jesus' name. Amen. I just want to join, and if Pastor Reed, and letting others know, in case you want to sit, there are still some seats. Not indicating that it's going to be a very long service, it's almost to the end, but in case you want to rest your legs a little while, there's some seats. I also want to acknowledge in the congregation, before I introduce the platform, I want to acknowledge some of my colleagues. I see Pastor Sobers here. I'm told Pastor Butcher. I'm not sure. I'm told, yes, Pastor Butcher is here. I also want to acknowledge some of the elders and members of the St. Thomas district. We are still debating that. Elder Justin and others from Blashma Hall, Jackman's, Bellier, and even I see from Hillaby, which was once a part of this district also. Thank you for your presence and support. Those who officiated and are officiating in today's service, my extreme left, we have passed, sorry. Yes, not yet. Maybe the Lord will lay his hands on him. Elder Llewellyn Watson, who is also a choir director, is one of our elders. Pastor Alvin Lucas, I don't want to say retired, retreaded. Pastor Jason Reed, who's also a neighbor. Yeah, a very, very close neighbor. And over to my right, Elder Wendell Harris, who is the first elder of the Rock Hall Community Group. Thank you all for assisting in this service. The ambivalence that surrounds the throne room of heaven because of Dawson's passing. Heaven sympathizes. We say heaven empathizes because the Bible says, for we have not an high priest who cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities, but one who was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. Jesus knows and identifies with us. Amen. And so there is the feeling of ambivalence. Yes, there's sadness. But the word of God declares in Psalms 116, verse 15, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints.
precious. And you may ask, why is death, how death can be precious? Let me hasten to say, it's not that God delights in death, for death is an enemy. The Bible states so, it's an enemy. But for the child of God who closes their eyes in death, which is as a sleep, for that child of God who closes their eyes in sleep, it's also heaven's victory. What am I saying? The prophet Isaiah in chapter 53, verse 11 tells us, he says, speaking about Jesus, he shall see the travail of his soul and shall be satisfied. When Jesus looks on and sees another soul in Dawson secured. Anybody hearing me? Understand this. We who are believers who are yet in the fight, we have to make sure that we endure. But Dawson has ended his fight victoriously. And so there is victory in heaven also. Another precious soul redeemed by his blood, saved from the clutches of sin. Amen? Thank you, Jesus. The devil can no longer attempt or afflict, do nothing to Dawson. And Jesus sees another soul who is ready. Someone whom he has completed his work in and whom has completed his work. Going to talk about those two elements as we go through. In Philippians chapter 1, verse 6, we are reminded, Paul says, being confident of this very thing, Glenda. Why take away your confidence, eh? Being confident of this very thing, that he which have begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. God, who have begun the work in Dawson, has finished it. The only thing is that is left now is when Jesus comes, he can put the icing on the cake. Glorification. When this mortal shall put on immortality, as the Bible says, and this corruptible shall put on incorruption. That's the icing on the cake. But as far as his salvation is concerned, secured. Anybody hearing me? I thought I had a little more believers in this house today. They're quiet. Okay. See, God does not start something that he cannot finish. As long as we permit him to, he will. Amen? Yeah. There are two things primarily that God wants to accomplish in us during this probationary period. And when we speak about probation, we mean the time that has been allotted to us to get ready for the judgment of God. Yeah. We are on probation. There is coming a judgment for every one of us. The Bible says that after death, there comes judgment. So this is probationary time. Time to get ready. Now, what are these two things that God wants to accomplish in us? Speaking of the church of Christ, the Apostle Paul says in Ephesians 4, 11 and 12, and he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, for the maturing, perfecting, the maturing of the saints, helping the saints to become like Jesus. Amen? And for the spreading the work of the gospel. God works in us and God works through us. Yes. Genesis reminds us that God created us in his image. Holy, perfect, good, righteous, all the good characteristics. That's how we were created. But because of disobedience, Sin entered into this world, and with sin came all the negative things you can think about. Sickness, suffering, disease, decay, death, pain. Think about anything bad, sin brought it. And so God sent his son Jesus on a mission of redemption. Amen. This mission was promised in the garden, Genesis 3:15, when God says that the serpent will bruise the heel of the seed, but the seed will crush his head. It was promised back in Genesis. But the Bible says then in Galatians 4:4-5, when the fullness of time was come, God sent forth his son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons. And when it was just right, Jesus came to bring salvation. Amen. And so Jesus came to restore that which was lost in the Garden of Eden. Yeah. He came to restore in man the image of God, the character of God in man, amen, through the process of salvation. That's number one, to restore the image of God in man, the maturing of the Christian. That is God's work in us. Yeah. And every day, he seeks with our cooperation to bring about that work in us, that we can be like him. But then there's also God's work through us. As he saves us, he in turn wants to help to save others through us. That's the work of the gospel. By the way we live, by our works and deeds, we tell others that we belong to Jesus. And I want to say to us today that God's work for Dawson was finished. In him and through him. It was finished. I know, Glenda, you might be saying, his work is finished, but what about me? He's gone and left me. God got you. Yeah. Got you, Glenda. A husband to the husband less he is. It's right. God's work in him is finished, but what about me? He got you too. He's a father to the fatherless. He's got you. It's not an afterthought. God already got his plan. And it's perfect. Thank you, Sister Reed, for the song. We don't always understand. I ain't claiming that. We don't always understand. We have our questions. But one thing we are sure about, he loves us so we can trust his heart. We can trust his heart. I have known Dawson for some 30 plus years now. He could almost have been a brother-in-law. I ain't saying no more. You figured that one out. But truth is truth. He could almost be. I would have met him while working with the late Pastor Lester Jones, who was at that time the district pastor. And I worked with him in crusades, and I think that was my first encounter. I also got to know him when I graduated, and I came back from college, and eventually I pastored the district, and so I got to know him as his pastor. He was a member and an officer of Baltimore Hall Church. I think he served as a deacon. Yeah. I subsequently was transferred from the district and served in other parts of the conference, and some 2 years or so
when volunteering to lead a project in Rock Hall is when I reconnected with Dawson. Glenda, Dawson's wife, a very committed Christian. Glenda became a member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church on something we call a profession of faith. She was already a believer. She was baptized in Christ, but there were some teachings that she wanted to be a part of, and she became a member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church. A very active member of the Seventh-day Adventist Church. Came with a passion, the passion she already had. Praise the Lord, amen. Subsequently, Dawson came. And it seemed to me, and I'm still subject to correction, but as if he had fallen away for a little bit. Yeah. But Glenda came and Dawson subsequently came. Thank God for good wives, amen. Yeah, praise the Lord. And good husbands. But it seems most of the time that the women come before the men do. I have no statistics, it seems. So it's out there. But Dawson came and he renewed his covenant with God. Yeah. He requested, he wanted to be rebaptized. He renewed his covenant with God. And he became very active. Yeah. Committed to the group at Rock Hall. He served as a deacon. Now, I'm not going to say anything you don't know. Dawson was not a loud person. He wasn't. He wasn't very bubbly and effervescent. We know that. That wasn't Dawson. But he was very committed and dependable. Very committed and dependable. Still waters, they say, run deep, and empty vessels make the most noise. I ain't saying no more. I believe that God gave Dawson another chance, and he grabbed it with both hands and devoted himself to God and his church. That's what I saw. That's what I saw. And when I thought of Dawson and his life, when I reflected on his life, this passage of scripture comes to mind, and I'm going to share it, and we're going to close. Micah chapter 6 and verse 8. Micah chapter 6 and verse 8. The Bible says, he have shewed thee, O man, what is good. And what doth the Lord require of thee? But to do justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with thy God. To do justly, to treat others fairly. Yeah, you know, to do what is right. To love mercy, to have compassion or forgiveness shown towards someone whom is within your power to punish them, to have mercy. And to walk humbly. Not, you know, not to be puffed up because we have nothing to glory about save the cross of Christ. Amen. To understand that we are no better than others. Had it not been for the grace of God, there goes I. There goes you. It's only because of Jesus. So we need to walk humbly before God. That's how I see Dawson. And Morley, I don't know if it's going to be the harmonica that he's going to blow, but he's going to play an instrument. I believe it might be a harp. And he would play it in tune. Praise the Lord. Amen? Yeah. Because someday we believe, as the Bible promises, we will see our loved ones who have died in Christ again, Glenda. And not just for a time, but the Bible says, never more depart. And with those words, Paul says, comfort one another. And so today I thank God for the life and legacy of Dawson. And I pray for us all that when our time comes, as it will. Hello? Yeah. It's real. When our time comes, that we too will be ready. Amen.
We want to thank Pastor Winston Cook, who is the pastor in charge of the Central District, for his words of cheer, encouragement. And two phrases come to mind. All who have an ear, let them hear. And a word to the wise is sufficient. Let's all stand for prayer. Our heads bow. Dear Jesus, we want to thank you for being with us, being with the friends, family, loved ones, church members, being with everyone who is here and in the hearing of my voice who've been a part of this service. We want to thank you for reminding us of our duty. Those of us who are alive, we have a job. We have duties to do. Help us, dear Lord, that we will recognize our purpose. Come divinely close to us. Show us our path where it's needed and necessary. Even now, as we about to go to the graveyard, Lord, we ask you to give us traveling mercies. We ask you to be with the rest of the proceedings throughout the remaining of this afternoon. Thank you for hearing and answering our prayers. This is our prayer. This is my prayer. For Christ's sake, amen. Our hymn of Recession is number 430. Number 430.
Oh, let me joy when the work is done. Joy when the reapers gather home. Bring in the Jesus set all sun to the new Jerusalem. Joy, 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 every joy by and by. Joy, joy, where the joy never died. Joy, joy for the day draweth nigh when the world. Sweet are the songs that we hope to sing. Grateful the face our heart shall bring. Praising forever Christ our King in the new Jerusalem. Joy, joy, every joy by and by. Joy, joy, joys never die. Joy, joy, for the day draweth nigh when the workers gather home. Pure are the joys that await us there. Many the golden mansions fair. Jesus himself doth then prepare in the new Jerusalem.
With your heart and lead me in your love to those around me. Jesus, the name above every other name.
ever say. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe, we'll live for you.
Let us pray. Our loving God, we pause to thank you again for the life of our brother Dawson. Thank you for your journey and mercies, and we ask for your continual presence in the form of your Holy Spirit to be with us as we do this committal. Bless the family, friends, all who are experiencing grief by this loss. Bear them up as you have promised on eagle's wings. In Jesus' name, amen. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not even as others with no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For as much as God in his infinite love and wisdom has permitted our dear brother, Dawson Lemuel Chandler, to lay down the burdens of his life and to fall asleep in Christ, we do tenderly commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in the sure and certain hope of a joyful resurrection when our Lord shall come in glory. Then this body of vile humiliation shall be changed and be made like unto his glorious body, according to the power whereby he is able to subdue all things even unto himself. Amen.
Let us turn to the hymns for the graveside in our leaflets. The first one, Faith is the Victory that Overcomes the World. That's on page 5.
Faith is the victory. Faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world.
Encamped along the hills of light, ye Christian soldiers rise and press the battle ere the night shall veil the glowing skies.
victory we know that overcomes the world. Faith is the victory. Faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world. On every hand the foe we find drawn up in dread array. Let tents of ease be left behind and onward to the fray. Salvation's helmet on each head with truth all girt about. The earth shall tremble neath our tread and echo with a shout. Faith is the victory. Faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world. To him that overcomes the foe, white raiment shall be given. Before the angels he shall know his name confessed in heaven. Then onward from the hills of light, our hearts with love aflame. We'll vanquish all the hosts of night in Jesus' conquering name. Faith is the victory. Faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world. Faith is the victory. Faith is the victory. Oh, glorious victory that overcomes the world.
For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Amen.
The Lord is my light, my joy, and my song. Our next hymn.
The Lord is my light, then why should I fear? By day and by night, His presence is near. He is my salvation from sorrow and sin. This blessed persuasion the Spirit receives. The Lord is my light, my joy and my song. By day and by night, He leads me along. The Lord is my light, my joy and my song. By day and by night, He leads me along. The Lord is my light, though clouds may arise, with stronger than sight, looks up to the skies, where Jesus forever in glory that reign. Then how can I ever in darkness remain? The Lord is my light, my joy and my song. By day and by night, He leads me along. The Lord is my light, my joy and my song. By day and by night, He leads me along. The Lord is my light, the Lord is my strength. I know in His might I'll conquer at length. My weakness in mercy His covers with power, and walking by faith He upholds me with joy.
Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's continue.
Standing on the promises of Christ my King is our hymn. Now, that's the final hymn, Standing on the Promises.
The first song.
Standing on the promises of Christ our King, the eternal angels and His praises sing.
This is one of God's precious promises made by our Savior himself. It says, let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. Amen.
All right, we'll just sing, go back to the second hymn we sang in the church. This one is, Oh, There'll Be Joy By and By. Acapella. Oh, There'll Be Joy By and By. You have your leaflets, right?
We do it acapella.
I believe so. Okay. Well, you sing while I sing and you're going to be right. Okay? Sing while I sing and you're going to be okay. Oh, there'll be joy when the work is done. Joy when the reapers gather home. Bring in the sheaves at the set of sun to the new Jerusalem. Joy, joy, where the joy by and by. Joy, joy, where the joys never die. Joy, 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 for the day draws nigh when the work gather home. Sweet are the songs that we hope to sing.
Grateful the thanks
our heart shall bring. Praising forever Christ our King in the new Jerusalem. Joy, joy, joy by and by. Joy, joy, joys never die. Joy, joy for the joy of night when the workers gather home. Pure are the joys that await us there. Many the golden mansions fear. Jesus himself doth them prepare in the new Jerusalem. Joy, joy, there'll be joy by and by. Joy, joy, joys never die. Joy, joy, for the day joys nigh when the workers gather home. This is my Father's world. And to my listening ears, all nature sings, and round me rings the music of the spheres, the very first hymn we sang in church. This is my Father's world, and to my listening ears, all nature sings, and round me rings the music of the spheres. This is my Father's world. Should it be sad, rocks and trees of skies and seas, his hand the wonders wrought. This is my Father's world, the birds their carols raise, the morning light, the lily white, declare their Maker's praise. This is my Father's world. He shines in all that's fair. In the rustling grass, I hear him pass. He speaks to me everywhere. This is my Father's world. Oh, let me ne'er forget that though the wrong seems all so strong, God is the ruler yet. This is my Father's world. Why should my heart be sad? The Lord is King, let the heavens ring, God reigns, let the earth be glad. Yeah.
he's going out. And if he bother, I'll bring one, but he's going out.
Let's bow our heads, please, for the benediction. Let's bow our heads. Let's be quiet now. Shh. Our Father in heaven, we are indeed thankful for the life of Brother Dawson Chandler. We have just laid him to rest, Lord, and he awaits the call of the life giver. But there are those of us who remain. What he cannot now do, Lord, we can do because we have life.
Amen.
Help us, Lord, to incline our minds towards the life giver because it is in him that we live and move and have our being. Now, until we meet again, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace, both now and forevermore. Let everyone say,
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Have a good evening.
Come on, everybody, get your feet happy. Let's go. Come on.
Right.
solo sogno l'orizzonte e mancano le parole. Sì, lo so che non c'è luce in una stanza quando manca il sole. Se non ci sei tu con me, sì. Le finestre mostrano tutto il mio cuore che è acceso. Chiudi dentro me la luce che ho incontrato per strada.
Sogno all'orizzonte manca le parole. Io sì lo so che sei con me, tu mia luna, tu sei qui con me. Mio sole, tu sei qui con me.